Good morning, students. Today I will take unit 5, embedded system application and development. So this is the syllabus of unit 5. So these are the topics: case study of washing machine, automotive application, smart card system application, ATM machine, digital camera. Let's see one by one. The first topic is washing machine. What is washing machine? A washing machine is a machine that is used to wash different kinds of clothing without requiring any physical work. You don't have to rub or squeeze the cloth to drain the water while you use a washing machine. The washing machine is often referred to as a cloth washer or just the washer. You can use the laundry machine to wash the cloth automatically without having to supervise the operation. Everything you have to do is load the cloth into the washing machine and choose the wash mode. The washing machine automatically measures the amount of water and detergent required, and it also set the timer for washing, rinsing and drying on the mode chosen and the number of cloth. There are two types of washing machine. The first one is top loading washing machine and second one front loading washing machine. Let's see the first type, that is a top loading washing machine. The cloth are filled from the top of the washing machine. In this machine, it is a fully electric laundry machine. There is a cover at the top, aids in the loading and unloading of a cloth in the circular vessel that serves as the washer as well as a rinser and dryer. So people who do not want to blend their bodies with putting cloth into the washing machine, choose the top loading washing machines. In certain part of the world, this washing machine is more common than front loading washing machine. Then second type, that is a front loading washing machine. This machine loads the laundry from the front. According to the research, front loaded washing machine use less electric resources, water and detergent, and provide improved washing result than top loading washing machine. So these are the rules of the washing machine. The first one is wash by spinning. Then second rule, rinse. Third step, drying. Fourth step, wash over by blinking. Fifth step, each step display the process stage, and last step is in case any interrupt, execute the remaining steps only. Okay, so these are the rules followed by the washing machine. Then the next slide shows the development phases for washing machine. Here step number 1, define the problem clearly. Then step number 2, estimate the development cost of washing machine. Then step number 3, analysis the future purpose or further purpose. Fourth step, develop hardware and software needed for that washing machine. Fifth step, debug both hardware and software. Then sixth step, release the product in the market. Perform a post implementation analysis to determine the product's performance. So these are the steps involved during the development phases for washing machine. This slide shows the various parts of the washing machine. The first part is water inlet control valve. A water inlet control valve is located at the washing machine's water inlet point. When you load the cloth into the washing machine, this valve opens and shut automatically based on the total amount of water needed. So the solenoid valve serves as the stream release valve. Then the second part is water pump. The washing machine, water is circulated by the water pump. It operates in two directions. During the wash cycle, it recirculates the water, and during the spin cycle, it drains the water. So this is the function of water pump. Then third one, tub. In the washing machine, there are two kinds of tubs available. The first one is inner tub and second one is outer tub. The cloth are poured into the inner shower, which washes, rinses and dries them. The water is drained into narrow holes in the inner tub. The outer tub protects and maintains the inner tub through the multiple washing cycles. The fourth part, that is agitator. This is also known as a spinning disc, which is a housed inside the washing machine tank. It is the crucial component of the washing machine that really cleans the clothing. The agitator rotates constantly throughout the wash cycle, creating strong rotating current in the bath, which causes the cloth to spin within the shower. The soil particles are removed from the fabric of the cloth by rotating the cloth in water containing the detergent. As a result, the agitator does the most critical function of the rubbing the cloth together along with the warmness. Instead of the long agitator, some washing machines have the disc that tightens the water flow. The next part is washing machine motor. The motor is connected to the agitator or disc and generates rotation. These are multi-speed motors with the ability to adjust the speed if required. The speed of the engine, that is the agitator in a fully automatic washing machine, varies automatically depending on the load. The next part is a timer. The timer helps the manually setting the wash time for the clothing. The time is automatically set in the automatic mode based on the amount of cloth in the washing machine and the type of a wash cycle being used. Then the seventh part is printed circuit board, that is a PCB. The PCB is made up of various electrical components and circuits that are designed to behave differently depending on the load, that is the condition and the amount of cloth loaded in the washing machine. They are artificial intelligence system that detect different environmental factors and make decision based on that information. These systems are also known as a fuzzy logic system. As a result, the PCB will measure the total weight of the clothing as well as the amount of water and detergent needed as well as the total time taken to wash them. They would then determine the amount of time available for washing and rinsing. Then eighth part, that is a drain pipe. The drain pipe is used to drain the dirty water from the washing machine after it has been used for washing. The next slide shows the various inputs and outputs of the washing machine. So these are the inputs buttons. So these are the outputs. See here, the first one is user push button, second one water temperature, third one drum speed, fourth one water level sensors, and fifth one door closer switch. Let's see one by one. The first one, that is user push button. If you press the button, the washing machine is on. Okay, so that is the use of user push button. So various buttons used for the interaction with the user. Okay, that is called as a user push button. Okay, then the second one, water temperature. So water temperature button, that is the temperature sensor senses the current temperature of the water and gives this temperature as an input to the controller. Okay, that is the use of water temperature. Then third one, drum speed. The current speed of the drum is sensed and this input is also given to the controller. And fourth one, water level sensor. This input gives current temperature of the water. Then fifth one, that is a door close switch. This is used to sense whether the door is closed or not. Okay, so these are the input of the washing machine. Then the output, the outputs of the washing machines are drum motor, water heater, water pump, water valve, user display and door release button. Okay, let's see one by one. The first one, drum motor, it is connected with the washing machine drum and it is used for rotating drum. The second one, water heater. So this signal is the output from the controller and the input for the water heater, which is used to switch on or off the heater. Then third one, that is a water pump. This signal is used to control the water pump of the washing machine. Then fourth one, water valves. This signal is used to open or close the water valve of washing machine. Then fifth one, user display. So it indicates the current ongoing activity and other signals related to the washing machine. Then door release button, it is the signal for releasing the door for the washing machine. So these are the inputs and outputs of the washing machine. Then this slide shows the control panel diagram for washing machine. In control panel, various knobs available. Control knob is the main knob. It contains load select knob, water inlet select knob, mode select knob and program select knob. Let's see one by one. The first one, that is a load select knob. Select the load type, that is low or medium or high load. Okay. So it depends upon number of cloth loaded in the washing machine. Then the second one, that is water inlet select knob. So the water temperature type, that is hot water or cold water or cold hot mixer type. So the user can set any one mode. Okay. Then third button, that is a third knob, mode select knob. This knob select the mode, that is save mode or normal mode. So the user can select any one mode. Then fourth one, program select knob. This knob is to select the heavy wash or normal wash or light wash or delicate wash. If cloth are very dirty, the user can choose the heavy wash, or if the cloth that is either heavy wash or normal dirty cloth, we can select a normal wash for program select knob is to program select knob is to select the heavy wash, normal wash, light wash, delicate wash. If the cloth are very dirty, the user can choose heavy wash or normal. Dirty cloth, we can select normal wash, or for light dirty cloths, we can select a light wash, or silk cloth, we can choose a delicate wash for that. This knob is used. Then, so this is the functional block diagram of washing machine. So here actually the operation of the washing machine is first fill the water, that is the water will be filled by the pump as per the load knob selected. Then after that, agitate means the wash basket will rotate in a clockwise direction for 10 to 15 revolution. After that, basket will stop for 2 seconds. Then rotate 10 to 15 revolution in anti-clockwise direction. The process will be continued for specified minutes in cycle table. Okay, so this is the function of agitator. Then third part is that is a drain. After agitation, the water and detergent are drained. Then fourth one, spinning. That is during spinning, agitator will be stationary. Only the basket will rotate at a high speed. Then the moisture of the cloth are removed through the holes in the inner metallic basket. Okay, then indicator. So here machine status, whether the machine is on or off. Okay, suppose a machine on means that is LED on. After completion of washing cycle, the buzzer sound will be generated. Okay, so this is about operation of the washing machine. So this is the block diagram of washing machine. Here the controller unit. Okay, the controller unit, that is one side of the controller unit connect a user controls button, then communicate interface, then memory, then sensor and signal conditioning. So these are all connected on one side of the microcontroller. Then other side, display control, motor control, buzzer and a beep driver, then relay drivers and the AC switching circuits. So these are all connected on the other side of the controller circuit. The for the controller, it needs a power supply and power on reset, power on reset. So this is a standard block diagram of washing machine. The principle of a washing machine is, the washing machine are very commonly used electromagnetic controlled home appliances. Modern washing machine are fully automatic. That is, they wash the cloth according to their type and degree of the dirtiness. The washing machine also detect the type of a cloth and then select the program for washing. The modern washing machine use microcontrollers or microcomputers with a sufficient memory and keyboard and display, etc. Facilities. The modern fully automatic washing machine use the advanced control technique like fuzzy logic to implement the washing algorithms. Such washing machine decide the wash cycle, then hot or cold water requirements, then agitate or spin or soak or rinse wash modes, then wash times, etc. on their own depending upon the volume of the cloth and the dirtiness. Okay, then the next slide shows the data flow diagram of a washing machine. The microcontroller connect the input devices like water temperature probe, then safety cutout switches, what that is wash program select knob, etc. on one side. On the other side, it connect the output devices like drum motor, heater, water suction pump, indicators, etc. So depends upon this information, the microcontroller give the instruction to the output devices. So this is about a data flow diagram of washing machine. The next diagram shows the control flow diagram of a washing machine. Here, if you press the start button, the washing machine is ready for its operation. It checks the door status. If it is closed, then it will move to the next state. Okay, that is fill water. Otherwise, it will wait for some time. If time exceeds, it moves to the fault state and indicates error message or warning through alarm signal. Okay, similarly, from fill water to heat water, after reaching required temperature, the next step is wash. After washing, it moves to the rinsing, then spinning, then washing the clothes, spinning, then the washing machine completes its function. During operation, if any interrupt occurs, it will move to the fault state after a specified time limit. So this is about control flow diagram of a washing machine. So first ready state, then fill state, then heat water, then wash the cloth, then rinse the cloth, then spinning, then stop the washing machine. Okay, stop the process. Okay, that is the meaning. Okay, so if any interrupt occurs means then it will automatically move to the fault state. Suppose the specified time limit exceeds means it indicate the signal, that is a through alarm or some other indication. Through this we want to identify what is the status of washing machine. Okay, then the next slide shows the flow chart of the washing machine. So here see the first step, start the machine, then set the load select knob, then water inlet select knob, then mode select knob and program select knob. If you choose a 25 minutes, okay, see here, if you choose a 25 minutes, so agitate for 5 minutes, drain for 5 minutes, then after that fill water, again agitate for 5 minutes, drain for 5 minutes, then spinning condition, this is for 5 minutes, then buzzer give alarm signal, buzzer for wash complete. Okay, so this is the indication. Okay, suppose 30 minutes means agitate for 10 minutes, drain for 5 minutes, then fill water, then agitate for 5 minutes, drain for 5 minutes, then spin for 5 minutes, then process over. Okay, if suppose 45 minutes means agitate 15 minutes, drain 5 minutes, fill water, then agitate 10 minutes, drain 5 minutes, spin 10 minutes, then process stop. Suppose 60 minutes means agitate 20 minutes, drain 5 minutes, fill water, again agitate 10 minutes, drain 5 minutes, then spin 20 minutes, then stop the process. Okay, so this is the flow chart for washing machine. Then the next slide shows the rotation of the motor. So the motor is connected with the agitator. So the agitator connects at A position. See here, this is position at A. Then the motor will rotate in clockwise direction. Suppose a B position means the motor will rotate in anti-clockwise direction. So agitator rotates both clockwise as well as anti-clockwise direction. Okay, the next slide shows the semi-automatic and fully automatic top loading washing machine. This is also possible. Let's look at the details of the two. Suppose a semi-automatic washing machine means this is the open loop type of a washing machine. The washer and dryer are in the separate tubs or vessels. Washing and drying times can be set separately using two timers. To wash the cloth, first place them in the wash vessel, then fill it with enough water and detergent, and then set the timer. Then the washing machine will turn off after the required amount of time has passed. You can either remove the cloth and hang them to dry in the sun, or you can partially dry them in the dryer vessel by setting a timer. Okay, so this is about semi-automatic type. Then the next one, that is fully automatic type. Okay, so fully automatic type means, so this is a closed loop type of washing machine. So that is used in a fully automatic washing machine. A fully automatic washing machine has a single tub that acts as the washer, rinser, then dryer.
the unit automatically takes in the appropriate amount of water and detergent and set the wash and drying timers based on the number of a cloth or the weight of the cloth. All you have to do is attach the laundry machine to the water supply, then place the detergent in its designated storage area from time to time and load the cloth. Then fully automated washing machine will take care of the rest of the things. Okay, so this is about fully automatic washing machine, that is a closed loop. Okay, washing machine has a closed loop control system. Then the next slide shows the automotive application. So here that is a inner working of a automotive embedded system. Here automotive embedded system are those in which electronics take charge of a mechanical system. The existence of an automotive embedded device in a vehicle ranges from basic mirror and wiper control to advanced airbag controller and anti-lock brake system, that is ABS. Automotive embedded system are typically equipped with microcontrollers, DSPs, digital signal processor, or a combination of two, and are referred to as electronic control unit, that is ECU, electronic control units. The number of embedded controllers in a typical vehicle ranges from 20 to 40, while a luxury vehicle may have 75 to 100 embedded controllers. Government regulation on fuel economy, environmental factors and emission standards, as well as the rising consumer demand for protection, comfort and infotainment push automakers to use sophisticated embedded control units inside the car. The microprocessor based fuel injection system was the first embedded system used in automotive application, that is a Volkswagen 1600 introduced the method in 1968. The different types of electronic control units used in the automotive embedded industry can be divided into two categories. There are two types of embedded control units. The first one is a high speed and second one is a low speed. High speed electronic control unit are used in critical stages, that is critical control units that require faster response, such as a fuel injection system, anti-lock brake system, engine control, electronic throttle, steering control, then transmission control and central control units. Then electronic control units for low speed, that is low speed electronic control units are used in application where quick response is needed. Okay. Time is not as important as it once, time is not as important as it once was. There are typically made up of a low cost microprocessor and microcontrollers. Then DSP, that is already you know, DSP expansion, that is a digital signal processor. So here DSP are used for audio controller, audio controls, then passenger and driver door locks, then door glass controls, among other things are included, that is a low speed electronic control units. For example, that is a LECUS, that is a low speed electronic control unit. Okay, then communication buses for automotive application, that is automotive communication buses. So actually serial buses are used for communication in automotive application, which significantly reduces the amount of wires needed within a car. So the various serial interface buses used in automotive embedded applications, The important automatic communication buses include control area network, that is a CAN, then local internet network, that is LIN, then media oriented system transport, that is MOST, and others. Okay, controller area network, that is a Robert Bosch, a leader of automotive embedded solution providers, proposed the CAN bus. It can transmit data at both medium and high speed. CAN is a protocol interface that is event driven and support error handling in data transmission. It is a commonly used in safety system such as airbag control, powertrain system such as engine control and anti-lock brake system, that is ABS, and navigation system such as GPS. Then a second protocol, that is a local internet network, LIN, is a bus. It is a single master multiple slave communication interface. LIN is a low speed single wire communication protocol that can accommodate data rates up to 20 kilobits per second and is commonly used for a sensor activator interfacing. Then the LIN bus employs the master communication triggering technique to remove the possibility of a bus arbitration issues caused by the simultaneous communication of several slave nodes linked to a single interface bus. The LIN bus is used in application where response time is not important, such as mirror controls, fan controls, seat positioning controls, window control, and local location control, etc. Then third one, that is a media oriented system transport, that is MOST. MOST is intended for interface automotive audio or video devices, especially in European vehicles. Most bus is a multimedia fiber optic point to point network deployed over a optical fiber cable in a sharp or loop or daisy chained topology. The physical layer as well as the application layer network, the physical layer or application layer, network layer, and media access control are all defined by the MOST bus specification, that is MOST bus specification. MOST bus is an optical fiber cable that connect the electrical optical converter and the optical electrical converter, resulting in the optical cable MOST bus, that is MOST bus. So far we have discussed what is the washing machine, what are the rules of the washing machine, then development phases for washing machine, then inputs and outputs of inputs outputs a functional block diagram, then control panel block diagram of a washing machine, control flow and data flow chart, rotation, open loop and a closed loop of washing machine, and automotive application. These topics are discussed in this video. So the remaining topics we will see in the next video. Thank you.